Welcome friends, all the points in our syllabus for the unit band theory of solids we have discussed in last few videos. Now in this video we will solve some numericals from this unit. So be ready with your pen and notebook and take the first numerical, first problem. See, this is the first problem. Compute the concentration of intrinsic charge carriers in germanium at 300K. Temperature is given, band gap is given, we know for germanium 0.72 electron volt, and effective mass of electron we take as mass of electron, it is also given, and the K is Boltzmann constant, it is 8.61 into 10 raised to minus 5 electron volt per Kelvin, and it is 1.38 into 10 raised to minus 23 joule per Kelvin. So this is in SI unit and this is electron volt per Kelvin. Okay, now we use our standard formula. Charge concentration, that is number of electrons or number of holes per unit volume. So Ni, I stands for intrinsic. So Ni is equal to number of energy levels or density of energy states into probability the energy level occupied. So this equation we have studied in one of the videos, so we directly use that. It is 2 into 2 pi m e star kt upon h square raised to 3 by 2 exponential minus a g upon 2 kt. Okay, so can we write this equation in this form? So what we do, this T we take outside the bracket. So we get here 2 into 2 pi m e star k upon h square raised to 3 by 2. This T we take outside, so T raised to 3 by 2, and this exponential term will be as it is. So if you look at these terms, see all these terms are constant for all materials and all temperatures. Okay, all these terms m star k h square, all these values are constant for any material, maybe germanium, maybe silicon, maybe diamond or any material, and for all temperatures. So once we substitute all these value and calculate, we can use this value in all such type of numericals directly, so not necessary to solve this bracket every time. So what we get, you put all the values, pi we know 3.142, m star mass of electron 9.1 into 10 raised to minus 31, and this is the value of h we know. Now this mass of electron is in kg and this Planck's constant, it is joule second, so these are in SI unit, so k we take SI unit value. It is 1.38 into 10 raised to minus 23. So please remember, when we solve this bracket, we take this value because it is in SI unit. So if we calculate this, we get 4.83 into 10 raised to 21. So this value is important. For next numericals, we can use this value directly. Now we solve next term, find out this T raised to 3 by 2, T is given 300, it is actually room temperature. So this is 5196 and KT. Now here K we take the value electron volt per Kelvin. Now why do we take it? Why don't we take SI unit? Okay, think over it. See, you can see we use this value in this equation, and this AG band gap, it is 0.72 electron volt, right? This is electron hole, and therefore K also we require to take in electron hole, and so we take the value 8.61 into 10 raised to minus 5 and we get 0.026 electron hole. So this value also you remember, you always remember at room temperature the value of KT is 0.026 electron hole. So put it here exponential. So we get 9.7 into 10 raised to minus 7. So put all these value, this value, this value and this value in this equation, and we get Ni, that is concentration of intrinsic charge carriers. So we get Ni is equal to 3.4 into 10 raised to 19 per meter cube, because it is concentration, means number of electrons per unit volume. Okay, so this the whole sum is before you. Just you look over it. I will wait for a few seconds. Yes, now we go to next numerical. So in that numerical we find the ratio. Okay, ratio of conduction electrons, means number of electrons in conduction band. Again we take germanium at a temperature 45 degrees Celsius and 27 degrees Celsius. See, first it is 45. So when you take the ratio, we have to take like this: number of electrons at 45 upon number of electrons at 27 degrees Celsius. Okay, so we use the same method. We use this method that we use in the first numerical. So what we do, we use the same equation, find N at 45 degrees Celsius. Then we find N at 27 degrees Celsius and we take the ratio. Okay, so I have solved for you. So let us take N1, number of electrons at 27 degrees Celsius, and N2 at 45. So first we find N1. The same equation as above. Now this bracket already we have solved, 4.83 into 10 raised to 21. Now at 27 again we get the T value same, 300 kT 0.026 at room temperature. Already we have solved it. So this value directly we get, because in the last problem we have calculated it. So N1 we get 3.4 into 10 raised to 19. Now we consider the temperature 45 degrees Celsius, it means 318 Kelvin. So T raised to 3 by 2, we get 5670.75, and KT we get 0.02738. K we know, T 318. Do this calculation, do this multiplication. And now exponential minus Eg upon 2KT, Eg 0.72, 2KT we have got it now. And we get 1.948 into 10 raised to minus 6. Okay. Now again, we put this value N2. This is the first bracket. It is T raised to 3 by 2. And this is exponential term. Do this calculation. We get 5.33 into 10 raised to 19 per meter cube. Now take the ratio N2 upon N1. N2, 5.33 into 10 raised to 19. N1. 1.948 into 10 raised to 19. So 2.736 we get, like this. Now we come to next. The fraction of conduction electrons at 300 Kelvin for silicon. It is silicon, we know 1.1. So fraction of conduction electrons, we have in one of the video we have solved it. Fraction of conduction electrons, we have solved it, and we know fraction of conduction electrons is nothing but the probability. We have seen this equation, f of ec is equal to exponential minus eg upon 2kt. Now we directly put it, eg we get 1.1, we know that, and 2kt we know 0.052. I have already told you 300 it is room temperature, it is 0.052. And we get 6.5 into 10 raised to minus 10. Okay, this was very simple problem. Now next, yes. Here, fraction of conduction electrons is given. Fraction of conduction electrons, it means probability, it is given. It is 1.7 into 10 raised to minus 47. So what we have to do, we have to find out the energy gap, and from the energy gap we have to identify the material, and we have to find out what is the type of material. Now fraction of conduction electrons means N upon N, we know that, and it is nothing but f of ec. Here we have seen, in one of the video we have seen fraction of conduction electrons, it is nothing but the probability, and that equation is exponential minus eg upon 2kT. So we have to find eg. So what we do? Correct, we take the log. So log and exponential, they cancel each other, and we get log of n upon n. So this log is log to the base e. So we write ln. So ln n upon n is equal to minus Eg upon 2kT. Correct? So Eg is equal to 2 minus 2kT ln n upon n. Now put the value 2kT, we know 0.052 because it is room temperature. Ln n by n means fraction of conduction electrons, it is given 1.7 into 10 raised to minus 47. So if we put it here, we get 5.59 electron volt. It is approximately the energy gap of diamond we know. So we identify the material as a diamond. And what is the type of material? See this energy gap 5.59, so it is greater than 2 electron volt. And we know if the band gap is greater than 2 electron volt, it is insulator. Now we come to next. Number of electrons near the top of valence band is given. Available for thermal excitation is 5 into 10 raised to 25 per meter cube. And intrinsic carrier density is 32.5 into 10 raised to 15 per meter cube at room temperature. Find the energy gap and identify the type of material. It is the same type of numerical as the number 4. It is indirectly given n by n. Fraction of electrons. See, these are the, this is capital N. This is number of electrons in valence band. Out of this, this is the number of electrons excited to conduction band. So what is the fraction? This is small n, this is capital N. So small n upon capital N is the fraction. I hope you are getting. See, number of electrons available, it is capital N in valence band. Out of capital N, small n number of electrons is excited to conduction band. So that excited to conduction band is this value and number of electrons in valence band is this value. So n by n, that is exponential minus Eg upon 2kT. It is the same type of problem. We take the logarithm. Eg is equal to minus 2kT ln n by n. Now kT again it is given at room temperature. So 2kT 0.052 ln 32.5 into 10 raised to 15 upon 5 into 10 raised to 25. So if we take the log of this ratio, again log to the base e, we get minus 21.154. So minus minus will become plus and we get 1.1 electron volt. Now we know 1.1 electron volt is a standard value for energy gap of silicon. And we know it is a silicon and this band gap is less than 2 electron volts. So we conclude it is semiconductor. Okay. So these are the some numericals we solve in this video. So okay friends, in the next video we will solve few more numericals. So we stop now. Thank you.